With summer somehow already coming close to an end and November getting ever nearer, we're getting very close to the 1 year anniversary that Apple released the HomePod Mini, a device that I bought right when it was released. So I'm getting very close to owning several of these for over a year. And as such, it made me realize how dependent I become on these devices and overall how much I've learned about them. And as such, I would like to share some of the information I've learned in regard to how well these devices perform for their price with you guys. Jumping right into it, I think HomePod Minis have an absolutely beautiful appearance. I really like the design that Apple has with the very minimal but high quality approach. It can fit into almost any room flawlessly. And I also really like the two colors that they offer. And I would like if they offered some more variety of colors. Additionally, as soon as you pick these up, you'll probably be surprised by just how high quality they feel in the hand, especially when you take into consideration that 99% of these will be opened, set on a shelf, and left there for the entirety of their existence. In the hand, I don't know how to explain it, but it just feels very durable. It almost feels like a rock in how heavy and dense it is. And the exterior is made from this durable but very nice looking foam or fabric of some kind. And the top has a glossy finish that does kind of look cheap from certain angles, but when you take into consideration this device's price, I'm extremely satisfied with its quality. It also does include a braided cable. Moreover, obviously, as I'm sure most of you know by now, these devices have really good sound quality, especially for their size. They're able to fill up almost any room with a substantial amount of noise, and the quality of that noise, once again, is of really high standard. And with the release of the HomePod Minis, a lot of cheaper manufacturers on Amazon also released their cheaper versions of Apple HomeKit accessories like light switches and smart outlets, for example. And with those two devices alone, you can make almost any product in any home feel like a smart product. For example, I have my two studio lights connected to Apple HomeKit, and I can show you guys right now how these lights were actually cheap lights, but I just plugged them into a smart outlet that cost me $20, and now they are smart lights as I can tell Siri to turn them on and off. I can simply just open the Home app and turn both studio lights on or off. As simple as tapping a button or telling Siri to do it. And that's because of one $20 smart switch. And the same thing applies to my fan, my overhead light, and all kinds of different things I have in my room connected to these smart outlets. However, something very important to keep in mind is the importance of having really good Wi-Fi. As you start to add more of these devices throughout your home, it will start to strain your Wi-Fi more and more. And the same thing applies to HomePod Minis. So be sure that you have good Wi-Fi, as it can get very frustrating when all these devices start not working or even glitching out and causing your lights to turn on and off randomly. And while that hasn't happened to me a lot recently, when we first got the HomePod Minis and we're setting everything up, there was a lot of that. So it's important to keep in mind that you might have to upgrade your Wi-Fi and getting a couple HomePod Minis and a couple smart home switches. Having said that, if you're just gonna get one HomePod Mini and maybe two smart switches and two outlets, there's no need to worry about that. But in my home, we probably have 5 smart switches and like 10 outlets with 4 HomePod Minis. So our Wi-Fi is experiencing quite a bit of strain. And like I mentioned earlier, there is sometimes some finicky things that happen, like Siri won't turn on or off a light. She'll just say she can't connect, which can be frustrating if you're used to being able to lay in bed, tell Siri to turn off the light to go to sleep, and then you have to get up and turn it on. A very first world problem, but a problem worth mentioning nevertheless, as it hasn't happened to me in a while. Like I said, it used to be a lot more common, but it still does happen every now and again, and I'm sure it'll be fixed with time as Apple starts to perfect the HomePod Mini. Next, these HomePod Minis are actually really nice and easy to set up nowadays. When I first got them, they were a little bit frustrating to set up, as once again, there's a lot of glitches. But now, as we get more recent ones, they're a lot easier to set up, and Apple has the whole system down to a much quicker science. So at the end of the day, overall, I'm really happy with my investment into the HomePod Minis. For less than $100, or right at $100, you are getting a device that allows you to play music in almost any room of high quality, access Siri at any time, and potentially turn your home into a smart home, all at a relatively cheap cost. So I'm really glad Apple released these, and after almost a year, I would definitely recommend investing in a HomePod Mini if you're looking to turn your home into a smart home. Thank you for watching, and please do consider subscribing, as only 2% of the people who watch my videos are subscribed. And as a small content creator like myself, any support really does help.